Happen Kraner get for on yeah. Happen Pushkes and Gallium on yeah.
Hello everyone. I'm going to do the first lesson of Scots Gaelic from the book Teach Yourself Gaelic. The first dialogue goes like this. Hello, Horomich. Hello, Virat. Kimara hau. Haguma tapalet. Kimara hau hen. Haguma tapalet. Hai brea anju. Hagu jerif. Ahoramich sho ishibil. Hello, ishibil. Smisa tournament makiver. Hello, Ahoramich. Smisa ishibil nikloch. Kimara hashif. Haguma tapalef. Kimara hashif hen. Mia nachma tapalef. Koasa hashif ahorimich. Hamia loas. Koasa hashif hen ishibel. Hamia san island skienach. Alright, now I'm gonna do explanation as well as pronunciation for each of these sentences. The first sentence is Hello ahorimich. Hello means hello. Ahoramich is directing it towards Tormit. This is a form of lenition. Lenition in Gaelic is a way of expressing emphasis on a word. It works for both names and any word you want to modify, really. To some degree of emphasis, you lenate the form of the word, which in this case is done by adding a before the name, an H after the initial letter, and an I before the final letter, which also changes the pronunciation completely, which is one of the things that throws off most English speakers when they learn about lenition. By adding an H after the initial letter, it changes the pronunciation of the letter. So a T by itself is pronounced the same as in English. However, a TH is not a th sound as in English, but just simply an H. It drops the T sound completely. And there's kind of a silent, or it's not a silent letter, it's pronounced, but it's sort of an invisible letter because it's not written. But anyway, there's an A before certain consonant combinations, as in the R and the M in Horimich, it becomes more like a ROM instead of just R or M. So it's Horimich instead of Hormage. And the D at the end, because the I is near it, it changes it completely. And the reason for this being is that there are two forms of vowels in Gaelic. There's the slender vowels as an I and E, and the broad vowels as an A, O, and U. Whether the consonant is next to a broad vowel or a slender vowel changes the pronunciation. If it was a broad vowel, it'd be pronounced as a D, but because it's a slender vowel, D's actually are pronounced as J's. This seems very strange to English speakers. However, it's just something you just sort of have to memorize and learn. Once you memorize the patterns, they generally stay the same, so it's not that difficult once you remember how it works. Second sentence is Hello, Virats. Kimara hau. Hello, Virat is again hello, Myrit, but the lenated form of the word Myrit. Kimara hau is how are you. In Gaelic, verbs generally come first in the sentence. However, if there's a question word like kimar, which translates to how, that will be first, and then verb will come afterwards. So in this case, kimara hau is how are you, so kimara is how, ha is the verb to be, and who is you. Haguma tapalet. Haguma is ha being the verb to be, guma meaning well or fine, good, so I'm well, I'm good. Tapalet means thanks, it's an informal form of thank you, because according to this dialogue, Myrit and Tormit are friends, so they're familiar with one another, so they use an informal speech pattern. Whereas later on, when Myrit introduces her cousin Ishibel, Ishibel doesn't know Tormit, so they use a more formal form of the language, and we'll get to that as it comes along. Kimara hau hen. Kimar ahau hen is the same as kimar hau, except for the hen at the end changes the emphasis. It doesn't change it, but it more emphasizes you greater than without. So it's like, how are you yourself? The FH, much like the TH, changes the pronunciation to just an H. The DH at the end of tapa isn't pronounced at all because it's again changed to an H sound. So generally, the rule of thumb generally is that H's following a consonant makes it an H sound in the beginning. However, this isn't always true. So just as it comes along, I'll tell you how it changes. Back to the hello, a virate section in the last part. I forgot to mention this, but the H following an M or a B changes the pronunciation to a V. In most dialects, sometimes it's a W. Irish tend to do a W if you're in the Ulster region of Northern Ireland. There's some Scots also use W sounds instead of V's, but generally speaking, it's a V sound. So just remember that M's and B's become V's with an H. Next line, Haguma tapale, we covered that. Ha ibreanju. Ha ibreanju is the ha is to be, we covered this already. E means it or she, a being he or it. Brea is beautiful in Gaelic, and anju is today. Pronunciation notes. A GH generally in the middle or of the word is actually pronounced as a Y sound, another form of the H changing pronunciations of consonants. Anju, we covered the DI thing already. The slender vowels change the D's to J's, and the GH isn't pronounced because it's at the end. Hagujerif means it is indeed, or some way of agreeing with the previous statement that the weather is beautiful or nice, it's nice today. Hi, Brianju. So, Hagujerif is she's just agreeing that the weather is beautiful today. She then introduces her cousin Isabel, so Ahoramet Sho Isabel, so Toramet, this is Isabel or Isabel. Pronunciation notes. Jerif, again, D with a slender vowel makes it a J. There's a hidden A between the R and the B, just like in Toramit. And the BH is a V again. And then, okay, so Sho Ishibel, when a slender vowel is near an S, it becomes an SH sound, as in the name Sean. So that's why it's not seen or some other or seon or some weird pronunciation like that. The SE makes it an SH, and then you just pronounce the AN afterwards. In this case, Sho, you just pronounce the SH and the O. And then Ishabel, it becomes Isha. The E is not pronounced, and the I and the E also make the S and SH sound.